Have you ever noticed how eggs sink in water but tomatoes float? Ice, which is made up of water, when it freezes, floats on water. Why do you think that happens? Do they behave similarly in oil? What happens when oil and water are poured together? Oil will always float above the water. This is because the density of water is higher than that of oil.
Let's see how to make this with the help of liquids that are easily available.
We will need castor oil, vegetable oil, colored water, and glycerin with one empty beaker with some different beads. Now, in the empty beaker, carefully pour glycerin. On top of the glycerin, very carefully pour the colored water. Notice how it floats above the glycerin. Our next layer is that of vegetable oil. Slowly pour the vegetable oil above the layer of water. Our final layer is that of castor oil. Notice how it is the lightest layer of all. Now my density meter is ready. Let's test it with different beads. Let's start with a ball bearing. Wow, it sinks. It must be the heaviest of them all. Next is a wooden bead, which floats on castor oil. Now a plastic bead, that has a density somewhere between that of water and vegetable oil. The lightest of them all is a thermocol ball, which floats above the castor oil.
Notice how liquids of different densities float above each other. At the bottom, we have glycerin, then water, then vegetable oil and castor oil.
Density of a material simply depends on how many of its particles are packed inside a particular volume. So make your own density meter with material that is easily available to you, that is all around you, and have fun with densities.